My name is Uttam Jodhavat. I am a PhD student at Department of Design and Manufacturing at Indian Institute of Science. My research work focuses on improving understanding of situation awareness at socio-technical systems level. So today I am presenting the work which is Diagnosing Facility Management Work Systems for Factors Impacting Situation Awareness on behalf of my co-authors. So this is the overview of this presentation. I will start with what is facility management today. What is situation awareness in facility management? Why do we need to diagnose the FM work system for situation awareness? How to diagnose? And what kind of result I have received from a field study? And what are the limitations and conclusion and future steps to move forward? So here you see there are two triangles. So the upper triangle shows for which the facility management works. So that is the core organization where the core business happens. So there we see there are built environment and there are people or the organization whom we are, the facility management is supporting. So the built environment has, now we have, the sophistication has increased of the built environment, but there is, at the back end we see there is the complexity of the technologies also. So there are the smart buildings, then we have smart infrastructure. And when we see towards the whom we are supporting, like the facility management supporting, so there is a large set of stakeholders to whom the facility manager has to support. So at the front end, the setting is complex. When we see at the back end where facility management has to work, so here also we see there are a complex network of actors. Few FM actors are outsourced, few are in-house, and there will be multiple facilities. For multiple facilities, there will be multiple teams. So it makes a complex network of actors. Then there are, in the past decade, we have brought new FM technologies also. And then the amount of, the scope of facility management we see, so it has significantly increased. So that makes the facility management also as a complex work system. So when I say work system, I mean people and technology together working as a system. So that is kind of, we can call it a socio-technical system also. So this is the setting where complex work system is working in a complex setting. But so like me saying that FM has become complex, so that won't justify it. So what I have done, Vicent has suggested a few some dimensions for analyzing whether a work system or socio-technical system is complex or not. So we have gone through those and we identified that if we talk about the facility management of large built environment, then FM has really become complex. So why I'm talking about complexity and complex settings? So when complex work system, like in this case, when there is a complex work system which is working in a complex setting, so that time achieving and maintaining situation awareness becomes challenging for the actors of the work system. So this is, I say, because this has been done in various, situation awareness has been studied in various other domains, like aviation, military, healthcare, and power plants. But we don't know what is the status in facility management. Okay, let me introduce here what is situation awareness. So situation awareness is formally known as perception of the elements in the environment within a volume of space and time, comprehension of their meaning, and the projection of their status in the near future. So this, this is an academic or generic definition which has been widely accepted, but I simply say knowing about what has happened, what is happening, and what could happen. So if we have this knowledge, then we can say we have situation awareness. So if when achieving or maintaining situation awareness become challenging, then it results in poor situation awareness, which results in poor performance outcome. But how do we define what is achieving and maintaining situation awareness? So there are two, at work system level, there are two two-level processes, one which is happening at the individual level, which is cognitive processes happening in everyone's mind. And at system level, there are different interactions happening between all the actors and technologies. And poor situation, I would mean incomplete, inaccurate, or outdated situation awareness. And this poor performance will be reflected in the everyday operation, and at the end will be visible towards the overall performance of the work system. So this is, I mentioned about complex work system in a complex setting, and FM is same. So that makes the case interesting for us to study situation awareness in facility management. And to conceptualize what is situation awareness in facility management. So we go with the, in terms of other environment, in other domain, we say the there are operational environments. So for us, the operational environment for facility management, the operational environment becomes the complex built environment where we have facilities, people, and organizations from which we get the FM actors get situation awareness. They make decisions and they act based on the situation awareness. So here the perception would mean recognizing the critical factors related to the built environment, understanding their significance and anticipating the future states and their implication. So we know situation awareness support or improve decision making, it supports performance. So this has been known from all the other domains, but what is missing in the literature is when we talk about technical and human agents working together. So we know how they get situation awareness, but there is a complexity at this work system level, which is how they get situation awareness and how the situation awareness is shared between them. So here the situation awareness of one agent modifies situation awareness of other agent, and one's situation awareness will help in the aid into the situation awareness of the other agent. So now I talk about why diagnosis of the FM work system for situation awareness. So I will start, what do we mean by diagnosing of the FM work system? So diagnosing is basically understanding and analyzing the FM work system for the aspect which can affect situation awareness in a work system. So here I see why diagnosis of the FM work system. So why I'm talking about situation awareness? So we know that SA is related to the performance in work system, and diagnosing for situation awareness would mean that we are contributing towards the diagnosing for the performance of the work system. Why work system? So it takes a systems view where we are not only focused on how individual or cognitive is getting situation awareness. We are looking into the systems level interactions also. So that is where we differ from the existing work. How the literature, how existing works are happening is basically they look into what kind of human errors are there in the situation awareness at the perception level, cognition level, or projection or comprehension level. But we differ from that and we look into the systems level. So why diagnosing? So diagnosis will support continuous adaptation and improvement of FM work system, and we know like what creates issues for situation awareness in a particular work system and how it creates situation it creates the issue. Now this is the overall research methodology followed for this work. So we from literature review we get the factors from different domain which affect situation awareness. Then based on this then we have a method. We use these factors to analyze a work system, whether these factors exist in this domain also or in this particular work system also. And this we have a method which I'll be showing in the next slide, upcoming slide. So this method can be evaluated and improved again, but we are not doing for this particular work, we are not doing it. So from literature, these are the different aspects of a work system, which are human, technology, team, task, or domain, and environment. So all these aspects have different factors which can impact situation awareness of an actor. But there will be complex interdependencies between all of these factors, which will finally result in poor situation awareness of the actors. But to diagnose with these factors, if there are new emerging factors also, how do we get to know these factors? So for that, this is the proposed method. What we are doing, so the objectives here are, we want to understand the work system thoroughly. Then we'll identify the performance issues in the work system. Then we'll see whether those performance issues are related to the situation awareness or not. If those are related to the situation awareness, then we want to know what are the causal factors responsible for those performance issues. Now, in terms of research methods, so we have done this method suggests in-depth interviews, direct observations, systems, and operator logs to get the data. Then qualitative analysis to understand the context of the performance issues which we get from this data. Then we have qualitative analysis to understand the causal factors for these performance issues related to the situation and awareness. Now this is how it looks in the action. So we this is one field study where we have applied this method on a facility management help desk work system. So here we interviewed. So this was where how it started. Basically, we have interviewed the actors of this work system. Then there were direct observations also. Then we have documented the information from the interview transcription and the field notes. Then we have the qualitative analysis to get what kind of situation awareness related performance issues are there. Then we have refined those performance issues for better understanding. Then we have verified those performance issues from the system sector. Then we have performed the second set of qualitative analysis where we are performing the analysis to understand what are the potential causal factors relevant to those performance issues. And if we come across new emerging factors, then we include into that list of the causal factors. But in this particular work, we could not involve the actors for this analysis. So this was done solely by the two researchers. The ideal case is where we want to include the systems actor also in the analysis because they have better understanding of their work system. So this is how the work system is understood, we say, based on the data. Based on the interview and observations, where we have a FM help desk work system, where there are two help desk executives working. Then there are one dedicated facility manager for the help desk work system. There are various facility management actors for different facilities. There are network of support teams which directly work for the to make changes or to do actions in the built environment. There is a continuous interaction with the clients. If there is any issue, service request or inquiry, then clients will connect with the help desk work system. And then also now building, they have building automated systems. They are alerts from the building automated system which they get, and they have to resolve those issues also as part of their help desk work system. So from the result of this study, what we have received in this particular work system which we have analyzed or we have studied, we have identified 71 situation awareness related performance issues and their causal factors, and there were additional factors also which we did not find in the literature from the various domains, so which are ineffective feedback mechanisms among actors, the complexity of the actors, network of actors, lack of accountability, lack of multidisciplinary knowledge, work constraint, lack of standardization, and poor data handling. So here, for the different aspect of the work system, we see how responsible each factor are towards impacting situation awareness negatively. So for the environmental aspect, we see there is one factor which is environment stressor. So that is related to the physical environmental condition, how whether there is a thermal comfort, whether there are loud noises, or whether is there any disturbances in the environment. So we found that is zero here, but the complexity of the environment is where there are many elements in the environment and which makes the understanding of the environment difficult for the help desk actors. So that is a more responsible factor from that aspect. In technology aspect, we find limited system capability. So this is where their technical systems are limited. They are not able to they have to do many manual works. Even if they have the technological system, they will be again handling Excel, even if the feature is available in the technology. Then from the human factor side, we see lack of knowledge and experience is the most responsible factor. Then second one is cognitive load. Then lack of adequate training, lack of multidisciplinary knowledge, lack of accountability. So these factors are. So then there are two more aspects, which are, one is the task and domain related factors, then one is the teams related factors. So in task related in the task aspect, we see lack of standardization of the processes, then complex network of actors, then ineffective feedback mechanism. So these are the more responsible factors. In teams aspect, we see the coordination and communication comes as the most responsible factor for impacting situational awareness in a work system, for this particular work system. So this is how we have a ordered frequency distribution of the responsible factors. So here we see ineffective communication, lack of knowledge and experience, lack of standardization of the processes, cognitive load, complex network of actors coming as the more responsible factors. Then at the left we see out of the loop syndrome, goals and expectation, attitude and environmental stresses is coming, like they didn't show up in the our analysis. So we have justification, like we have reason out why that is happening. So out of the loop syndrome is where the things are, if we have automated system and human will be out of the loop. They won't know what has happened, and we'll lose the situation awareness. So basically here the FM help this executives were responsible to continuously be in interact, be in touch with the all the actors. So it didn't happen for them. So they were actually continuously interacting. So for the so this is where when we want to apply this method, we need an adequate understanding of the all the factors impacting situation awareness. Some factors will be difficult to reason out, such as how the goals and experience of a person impact situation awareness, how the team's attitude will impact situation awareness. So here this the result which I have shown, just it shows the how each factor is responsible. It does not show how much impact this particular factor create in impacting situation awareness. And this particular study from this will act as a reference point from where we can actually intervene in the system to address these issues found and to work towards the. So so this developed method helps in identifying SA impacting factors. This will need further development because we are only able to identify the factors. We are not able to address this factor. Right now only one field study is conducted with this particular method. We have to do more of the studies so that we can verify its applicability. So this method is actually developed for the facility management professionals. Right now researchers have the, we have the background to understand all the factors. So we have this expertise to know this, so it has to be kind of made in a practical tool so that they can use it. And this method is potential of generalizability beyond the SM work system also. So the future work will look into that also. Okay. Thank you so much.